A very good morning, students. As we have started with the 10th standard science, the chapter Our Environment. So, in this chapter, in the previous classes, we have discussed with the meaning of environment, ecosystem, food chain, food web. Right? So, let us study the continuation part. Because of the human activities, like increased population, deforestation. So there are so many reasons, students. Because of that, we are polluting our environment. When we pollute our environment, directly or indirectly, it will affect to human beings. Because the human beings are the one which will come under the highest tropic level, we can say. Because ultimately, if you are disturb the aquatic ecosystem, terrestrial ecosystem, whatever it is, finally we are going to suffer, right? So we are going to discuss the today's topic, that is how our activities affect the environment. How do our activities will affect the environment? Because of our activities, we find called as biomagnification. It is also called as biological magnification. Biological magnification. What is biomagnification? See, students, let me start with one example. Like pesticides. You are using so many types of pesticides just to improve your crops, right? To improve our crops, we are using the pesticides. So these pesticides, what we'll apply to our agricultural crops, some percentage will be there in the crops and the remaining will be in the soil. Along with the rainwater, these pesticides will reach the nearby water resources, right? So it is nothing but these are the chemicals which are entering the ecosystem, aquatic ecosystem. It will affect the producers, consumers, and even the human beings who are all consuming the water, or it may be the fishes and all. Okay, so at last it has entered to the body of human beings. And I said few percentage of pesticides will be there in the crops, and those crops we people are having. So what happens, students? Those chemicals have entered our body. So directly or indirectly, at last we are the ones who are all going to suffer. Even other organisms will suffer. So like this, whatever you are using the chemicals, it may be the pesticides, it may be the DDT, we are using it to kill the mosquitoes. But what happens? Again it will reach the aquatic ecosystem, transferring to the other tropic levels. So finally it will reach the human body. So what we want to say, this is a chain type. What happened here? Whatever the toxic substance, chemicals are there, because of the human activities, they have transferred from one tropic level to another tropic level, but at last they have reached the body of human beings. Who started this all? Human beings. At last, who is going to suffer? Human beings. Right, students? Not only human beings, side by side you are disturbing and destroying your other types of non-biodegradable and other types of biotic components also. Right? So that is called as biomagnification or biological magnification. Right, students? Take down the definition. Biomagnification is the process of increase in the concentration of toxic substances substances at each successive tropic level. At each successive tropic level, right? Examples like pesticides, DDT, many types of chemicals, all these are comes under harmful or biomagnification causing things. Hope you are taking down, students. Our next concept is about ozone depletion. The next concept is ozone depletion. Before we start with the depletion, first let us study about the ozone. As we all know, ozone nothing but the three atomic form of oxygen. Triatomic form of oxygen is the ozone. In our stratosphere, what happened? Because of ultraviolet radiations, the oxygen, the free form of the oxygen means which was there in the O2 form of oxygen, because of ultraviolet radiations, it has converted into single atoms of oxygen. So these single atoms of oxygen have combined with atmospheric oxygen to form O3, and this we are going to call it as the ozone. Sorry, that is called as the ozone. So in our stratosphere, it has covered with the ozone. As we know the usage of the ozone layer, students. So these ultraviolet radiations are having the harmful effects, right? So these are all having the high energy effects, ultraviolet radiations. So if they enter the Earth's surface, imagine there is no ozone and these ultraviolet radiations have reached the surface of Earth. What happens? They may cause many problems. They may cause skin cancer, skin related problems. They may cause some of the problems to our eyes. It may be the cataract or some other eye problem we may find. Or it may be annual rainfall, it may get affected. Or they may affect the crops. Right? So one way and the other way, these ultraviolet radiations will affect the components of the earth. Right? So here we find the stratosphere, we find a thick layer of oxygen called ozone, which will not allow these ultraviolet radiations to enter the earth's surface. So it is nothing but we can say one protective shield it is to us. Right? But nowadays we are talking about ozone depletion. What is this depletion? Yes, because of human activities. What's happening? Like, it may be the air pollution. It may be, as just now I said, increased population. It may be the deforestation. Because of the human activities, not only these activities, we are using many types of electronic instruments, right? So like it may be the refrigerator, it may be the coolant, it may be the fire extinguishers, and all these are releasing the substance called CFC. Chlorofluorocarbon. So this chlorofluorocarbon, okay, this what happens, along with the ultraviolet radiations, it reacts and it will produce the chlorine gas. And these are all the things which are depleting, which are reducing the concentration. problem has started with a decreasing the concentration of oxygen. That is nothing but the ozone, and this is the problem we are explaining it as ozone depletion. Right, students? So what is our duty? Less usage of a CFC, controlling the air pollution, usage of the vehicles, it may be some other activity which will affect the environment. Grow more and more trees. So this we can say as the remedy for ozone depletion. Right, students? So this is one concept about how the human activities are affecting the environment. The second concept, students, when we talk about the garbage management, first let us study, we are, because of activity, so many wastes will be producing. Those wastes we are dividing in two categories. As you know, the one has biodegradable and another one is non-biodegradable. Biodegradable wastes and the non-biodegradable wastes. As you know the meaning, students, biodegradable means what? Something you are throwing, the microorganisms will start their action on that. They will decompose it, right? So that those are called biodegradable. The things, the substances which are all getting breakdown with the help of microorganisms are called biodegradable. Which are all the examples, students? Yes, it may be the human body, vegetable peel, plants, right? So many examples, totally paper, these examples comes for biodegradable. What's the meaning of non-biodegradable? See, non-bio, the substances which will not get decomposed by the action of microbes are called non-biodegradable, right? It may be the glass, it may be the plastic, it may be the metallic substances, right? So these are all the examples comes for non-biodegradable wastes. Coming back to our concept, that is garbage management. Nowadays at least we are all strictly following, students, hope you are also following in your houses, that whatever the wastes are there, we are dividing into two categories. Kitchen waste, paper, these all in one side. Plastic bottles, cans, tins, glass items, broken glass, bangles, that is all one waste. Means what? We are dividing as biodegradable and a non-biodegradable. Right? So biodegradable, one side, as they can use it for different purposes. If it is cow dung, vegetable peel, much is there, kitchen waste and all, they will prepare the biogas, as you know, students. Right? And even they can prepare the compost also. With the non-biodegradable, as these will not decompose, if it is few types of plastics, glasses, metallic substances, can we undergo recycling process? These are all can undergo the recycling process, right? So like this, you have to separate so that you can do the garbage management, right? And nowadays we have a habit of using use and throw bags, use and throw cups, plates, spoons and all. And that is all made up of the plastic substance. So instead of that, you have to take the paper thing, which is quite hard one, paper plate, paper spoons, that type of the substance we can use. Otherwise, we can use the soil. Otherwise, there are some plant products which are quite hard that we can use as a plates and all. So totally students, we have to avoid the non-biodegradable things and we have to switch on for biodegradable, right? So plastic bags almost it has banned, right? So you have to carry the paper bag or you have to take the cloth bag, right? So it is not only the responsibility of the government, it is the responsibility of all the citizens, means all of us, because we are going to suffer in future, not only us, our next generation. So it is our duty to avoid the non-biodegradable things. There are so many things, students, if we think, so many ways are there, with the help of that, we can save our nature, we can do the garbage management, and we can avoid the non-biodegradable waste. Right? So, this is one chapter which gives us awareness, which tells us about our activities. Right? So, this completes the lesson, our environment. Hope you are understanding, students. Please go through the textbook, read it. Next class, we'll go through the new chapter. Okay? Thank you.